Daredevil is not a guy you usually want to get involved with. Welcome back, Nerd Squad. Despite his charm and his smarts, Daredevil had a pretty awful track record when it comes to romance. Today, we're here to talk about some of the folks from that track record and what went wrong, or what was pretty much always really odd, as we count down the top 10 weirdest Daredevil romances. I hope you're ready to delve into some of this weirdness, because it is time to get counting. Number 10, Candace Nelson. That time when Daredevil very briefly dated Foggy Nelson's sister. Oh yeah, Foggy has a sister. Apparently, this happened so quickly. It's basically the smallest blip on Daredevil's love line, I'm sure, when it comes to palm readings. Candace is Foggy Nelson's younger sister who is studying journalism at ESU and ended up doing some snooping and attempted to expose the government and university for some involvement in some super shady activity. She and Foggy have always been at odds because she sees him as the way too stiff establishment type, and he sees her as the rebel who thinks that she's above the law. In the end, she and Daredevil had a bit of a thing at a time when Daredevil was pretty much wanted by every woman who appeared in his comic, including Natasha Romanoff, Black Widow. Oh, and after years of being friends with Foggy, Matt didn't even know that he had a sister till we got past the 100th issue of Daredevil, which is pretty weird. It's also implied later on that she is way too young for Matt. Also, her face is something else in that whole issue where that comes up. She's like, "I missed you." And I'm like, "What's going on? You look crazy, Candace." Number 9, Elektra. While Elektra may be one of Daredevil's greatest loves, it doesn't mean she can't be one of the strangest as well. It all boils down to the fact that Elektra is a really intense anti-hero when she's not busy being a villain. She's an assassin who has zero qualms with killing anyone in her way, which makes those two a kind of strange match. However, their costumes match really well, which is likely meant to symbolize some of the similarities that these two have. They are both intensely skilled fighters with a lot of darkness in their past and their present, to be honest. Their present. Well, yeah, because Elektra did come back to life, so it did happen. She has a present, even though she did. However, Elektra kind of paved the way for all the death and destruction, it seems, that dating Daredevil seems to bring to most of his partners. So there's also that. Number 8, Becky Blake. This is a pretty weird one, mostly just because it seems like Becky Blake and Matt's relationship is very one-sided and has always remained that way, and yet Becky never gives up. But also because Becky is another character who has just suffered a lot of trauma and tragedy, some of which was caused by Matt Murdock himself, and some of which was not. While many people might know Karen Page as the sole secretary for Nelson and Murdock, after there was Karen, there was Becky. Becky herself lost the use of her legs after suffering an attack by Michael Reese, who Murdock would later bring to justice. Becky would consistently express her feelings for Matt, who seemed conflicted, before deciding he wasn't interested. Maybe it was his relationship with Karen, which was also a huge mess, that ultimately affected his decision. Either way, Karen remained a friend to Matt for a long time, despite all the crazy stuff he put her through. In fact, she even also became a lawyer and joined their firm for a while. Eventually, however, she chose to firmly distance herself from both Matt and Foggy after having a near-death experience and felt that Matt Murdock was no longer worthy of her trust. And she was like, desperate for him for so long, and I'm just like, wow, that one thing though, she's like, and that's it. I was super into you, but I can't anymore. Number 7, Moondragon. Yeah, this was a weird one. A brief one. But a weird one. Daredevil and Moondragon had a brief infatuation with one another in Daredevil issue 108. After he leaves Natasha, Black Widow, who also has the hots for him, she mourns the loss of Matt, knowing that he has eyes for Moondragon. What? Okay, so even if we ignore the fact that Moondragon is usually presented later as being a gay character in the comics, this is still a really weird ship. The two are described as being inexplicably drawn to one another, but ultimately decide to go their separate ways, because they are galaxies apart. Well, literally. I also love that Moondragon originally explains that they can't be together because of their respective orientations toward life in the cosmos, apparently. They also, I believe, one time like psychically mind melded, which is pretty sexy for Moondragon, I think. She's like, let me get into that beautiful, brilliant mind. Number 6, Dakota North. I mean, this one made sense in terms of how it kind of came about, and it wasn't a full-on romance specifically, but these two did hook up. It all went down after Matt had suffered a pretty big loss and was still technically married. After the hookup, the not-so-great part was that pictures of these two doing the deed were circulated, because Kingpin is obsessed in every way possible you can imagine with Daredevil. They ended up on the front page of all the newspapers, which was super awkward for both Dakota and Matt, and also for a time cost Dakota North, pretty unfairly if I might add, her reputation. Matt came out mostly unscathed though in comparison, although there was definitely a cost for him as well when it came to these pictures. The images made everything super weird between the two going forward. And kind of awkward for, I think, a lot of people in that comic. There were a lot of people that were like, ah, what's happening? Number 5, Karen Page. Karen Page has to have one of the most tragic stories out of all of Daredevil's love interests. One of, anyways, because as I said earlier, there's a lot of tragedy here. Karen and Matt had an on and off again romance that eventually resulted in Karen's death at the hands of Bullseye. Surprise, surprise. Karen betrayed Matt by selling out his secret identity due to a drug addiction. However, she did return to warn him afterward. In the end, Matt and Karen came back together despite the revelation that she had been the one to sell out his secret identity in this case and had betrayed him. She got clean and the two of them got back together. They would later break up again and get back together a few more times, with Karen even forgiving Daredevil for faking his death and helping him when he had a crisis where split personalities appeared to emerge. Which kind of makes sense given his dating history, but we'll get to that later. They had the most rocky romance likely in comic book history overall, and Karen actually gave her life to save Daredevil. But also, she went through some crazy stuff, I feel like, because of Daredevil. Ah! Poor Karen Page. RIP. Number 4, Mila Donovan. There are fates worse than death, and that seems to be what Mila Donovan got when it comes to her relationship with Daredevil. She was driven insane by Mr. Fear, who had been targeting her for months and posing as her therapist after she ended up marrying Matt Murdock. She was driven insane, killed someone as a result, and ended up being locked away for her own good when private care also wasn't working for her. In the end, her husband Matt was denied visitation rights while Mila was in treatment, as it was believed that he was actually the cause of all of her problems. Yikes. Her parents attempted to get custody of Mila again after they learned of everything that had happened to their daughter and blamed Matt, which is, I mean, it's kind of fair, to be honest. In the end, Matt agreed to their request after pictures of him sleeping with Dakota North surfaced. Overall, he was just going through a lot and he needed a shoulder to cry on, which ended up turning into a weird relationship with Dakota, which we talked about earlier. Matt had been attempting to lobby to get Mila freed from the mental institution, but in the end, he acknowledged that he just needed to let her go. Bullseye did attempt to kill her when she was made one of his targets, but fortunately, Daredevil had already predicted this play and had Black Widow on standby to protect Mila. All in all, this relationship became all kinds of messed up, and I'm still amazed that Mila is alive today. And before we move on to our number 3 spot, just a quick little reminder to give this video a thumbs up if you can, if you will. It really does help us out here at the channel, and thank you for doing so. Number 3, Heather Glenn. Heather Glenn is another weird partner for Daredevil in that her story was also deeply tragic. I guess this is becoming no longer weird since everybody's story is deeply tragic. She was a beneficiary of his, a wealthy socialite that he ended up dating. In his Daredevil guise, he ended up saving her father from Purple Man, Kilgrave, who had been controlling him. However, her father was so distraught when he found out all that the Purple Man had made him do that he still took his own life while he was in prison. In the end, his daughter would follow suit. She blamed Daredevil for her father's death and attempted to betray his secret identity multiple times to get back at him. Still, somehow, Matt got past that and Heather got past her own hatred of DD, and the two ended up engaged. In the end, however, Heather took her own life, hanging herself after she became distraught when criminals destroyed her business. Which, of course, she also blamed Daredevil for. And which, he once again may have deserved that blame. Maybe. Number 2, Black Cat. This is a pretty random one. Black Cat isn't someone you'd associate with Daredevil, mostly because she is usually so obsessed with Spider-Man that everyone she has ever been with outside of Peter Parker tends to have to do with some kind of play of getting back at him or something to do with Peter himself. For Black Cat, it's usually all about Spider-Man. So, how did this come about? Well, it all went down when Spider-Man recruited Daredevil to help him free Black Cat from prison. But while they were developing a legal strategy, Black Cat herself escaped and the two of them had to track her down. It was during this time that Daredevil developed an attraction to Black Cat and she to him. Although for Black Cat, there still really only seems to be one true superhero for her, as both she and Daredevil admitted that their relationship was more of a fun physical thing than anything serious. Although I guess I'm not super surprised that they're attracted to each other because they're both like hotties, but I'm also just like, this is like a random thing that someone was like, what if they got together? Everyone's like, I mean, I guess, why not? Number 1, Typhoid Mary. Typhoid Mary has got to be one of the strangest pairings for Matt, especially considering he was the one that caused all the grief in her life after he knocked her out of a window. True story. This trauma brought forth from Mary 3 split personalities, at least 3, which are later kind of explained as being part of past trauma, but were kind of just triggered into resurfacing by Matt's accidental influence. by his accidental violence, really. Still, you can pretty much blame Matt for creating the villain that became Typhoid Mary. One of these personalities was that villain, another was hypersexual, and the third was much more modest in comparison to the other two. I guess the most normal of all three personalities, really. These are the most commonly acknowledged personalities, but she also appears to have other lesser utilized personalities when it comes to the comics, such as Mutant Zero. Daredevil for a time was involved with all three of her main personalities, but it gets weirder. A frequent ally of the Kingpin, Mary has also attempted to kill Matt multiple times. Oh, and while she is a mutant, she only seems to be able to access her mutant abilities through certain personalities. Weird. There are so many different kinds of weird in this list. I love that Daredevil has some of the most diversely strange romances. From dating villains, to death, to kinda just ruining people's lives by just being in them. Or dating his best friend's sister. If you date Daredevil, you pretty much know in some capacity it's already weird, or it's about to get weird, and possibly get tragic. Who would you want to see Daredevil paired up with? Are there any romances that you wish had stuck or had a happier ending when it comes to his loves? Let us know in the comments below. This has been Top 10 Nerd, and I'm your host, Amanda McKnight. Till next time, you stay nerdy, YouTube.